So one of my favorite things about engaging with the students who complete my course called Lightroom Everywhere, the link's in the description below, is learning how they have their photo workflows set up. That's a very personal thing. Everyone has their own way of doing things. But what surprised me, but probably shouldn't have, is that how many people actually want to use their iPad to do, if not all of their photo management, so their organization, their editing, and their sharing, then at least most of it. Some of them have the desktops and they use them, but they definitely prefer to use the iPad. Now, I kind of fall into that bucket too. I use my iPad to manage and edit my photos almost exclusively. Like, it's what I use, I would say, 85% of the time. But if I had a wish, it would be that the features that Lightroom Desktop has matches what Lightroom Mobile has. Specifically, one feature in particular called Photo Merge. So when I say photo merge, I mean the ability to combine multiple images together. And in two specific cases, that would be for tone mapped HDR photos and panorama stitching. Now, unfortunately, at the time of recording, you can't merge to HDR or Pano using Lightroom on the iPad or the iPhone. I do hope it comes, but the good news is that I actually found a way to do that. The bad news is that it's an extra app and it has a cost to it. But the good news, if we're going to sandwich this together, good news, bad news, good news, is that this app is actually really good. Like, if you spend the money on it, you're going to get your money's worth. And that app is called Affinity Photo 2 for the iPad. So in this video, I'm going to show you how you can get your photos from Lightroom into Affinity Photo 2, specifically to do an HDR merge and a Pano stitch so that you can have the best of both worlds. Now, hopefully one day Adobe will add the ability to do an HDR merge or a Pano stitch in Lightroom on the iPad. But until then, this is actually quite a capable alternative. So let me show that to you right now. All right, so here we are in Lightroom. I have this album created and you can see there are two sets of photos. The first five photos are meant to be tone mapped as an HDR photo and the remaining nine photos are meant to be stitched as a Pano. So really quickly, the reason why you would want to tone map an image is if I open this up over here, you can see that it's a very challenging exposure because there's very bright areas and there are very, very dark areas. And I could try to bring out some of the shadow information and the highlight information, but depending on the capabilities of your camera sensor, that might prove to be challenging. So what you can do instead is take multiple exposure brackets. So this is zero exposure. This is a negative one, so it's exposing for the highlights. And as you can see, we're starting to lose shadow information. This is plus one, so this is exposing for the shadows. This is minus two, so here you can see we have all of the highlight information we could possibly need. And then this is plus two, so we have all of the shadow information, but it comes at the expense of the highlights. So what we want to do is combine these five photos to create a tone-mapped HDR photo. Unfortunately, you can't do that on the iPad. If this was on the desktop, this would be a snap. I'd select the five photos, right click, go to photo merge, and then select HDR, and I'd be done in seconds. But fortunately, there is an alternative, so I'm gonna show that to you right now. All right, so in terms of editing an HDR photo, I highly recommend not doing anything with the exception of something like white balance, if you're working with a raw file, which I am. So here, all I did was under color, you can see with white balance, it's set to custom. I achieved a custom white balance and then I copied that by selecting this image and tapping copy on the bottom. And then I selected the remaining four photos and tapped paste, which you see the icon on the bottom there. And that pasted the settings. So now all five photos have a correct and synced up custom white balance. Now we need to get the photos exported as files. So this is kind of different than what you might be used to. Normally, when you export out of Lightroom, you'll select your photos, you'll select the share button, and then you'll tap on save copy to device. But we don't want to do that because that's just going to save the photos to the camera roll. The way that I prefer doing it is by saving them as files first. Now, this is my way to do it. You can certainly adapt this to your own needs, but let me just show you how I do it. So I'm going to tap on export as, and you can see under file type, we have a few different options. I did try the DNG option, but for some reason, I'm not sure if Affinity Photo 2 has full DNG support, because when I opened up the DNG file, it did not see any of my edits. It just gave me the original photo. So for the purposes of this workflow, I'm going to show you how to work with a TIFF, which is more than enough information. So we're going to tap on TIFF here. I make sure that the dimensions are largest available dimensions. I also am working with 16 bits for the bit depth. And then the last thing you'll do is go to more options. And for output sharpening, I typically work with screen and standard for the amount. And then color space, if I were just sharing these photos to social media, I would use sRGB. But because I'm going from one photography app to another, I'm going to stick with the Pro Photo RGB color space. Let's hit back here. And then the other thing is, this is up to you, but if you want to apply a compression to your TIFF file, you can do that and it'll reduce the file size. But for the purposes of this, I'm okay with going with none. And so now I'm going to go and tap on the check mark. Lightroom will start rendering out those five TIFF files, and then it's going to give you an option to save it. And for me, I'm going to tap on save to files. And now I can browse to a folder where I want to save these five TIFF files. I'm going to tap on my iPad, and then I'll tap on Affinity Photo, which is created when you install the app. And in here, the logs folder, that's created with the app, but I already created two separate folders. As you can see here, there's HDR and Pano. So we're going to do an HDR here. So I'm going to tap on that, then tap on save on the top right. And now you can see that Lightroom saved those five photos. Now it's time to merge. So let's swipe up here, and you can see to the right of the Photoshop icon in my dock, that is Affinity Photo 2. Now, I already mentioned this, but there is a cost involved with this. So I want to be upfront with you. To do these things, you need Affinity Photo 2. When I looked on their website, Affinity Photo 2 for the iPad was $18.49. It's a one-time payment. So it can do a lot. It's kind of billed as a replacement to Photoshop, which I'm not truthfully interested in. I love Photoshop, and I like to stick under the Adobe Creative Cloud umbrella. But in these situations, if I'm traveling or if you are an iPad only user and you really want to be able to stitch a Pano or tone map an HDR photo, this is a functional process. And for $18.50, I know it's pricey, but it's actually a really cool app. So let me show you how to do that. All right, so I'm going to launch Affinity Photo here. And on the left, the first thing I'm going to do is tap on new. And you can see the things that I really want are the HDR merge and the panorama. The cool thing is also for the focus stacking lovers out there, you can also do a focus stack right within this app. So again, there's a lot that you can do here. But like I said, the first thing we're going to do is merge an HDR. So I'm going to tap on new HDR merge, and then we need to load the images in. So I'm going to tap on this cloud icon here, and I'm already in that folder with the five TIFF files. So I'm going to tap on all five of them and then tap on open on the top right of this window. Now, the only option that I'm going to disable is the noise reduction, because I don't want to add that as part of this process. I don't think it needs it, but I will have the other options enabled. And then all you need to do is tap on OK. And here we have our HDR photo. This is a tone map photo. Now, you could use the editing tools here. Like, for example, if I tap on this top right icon, you can see we have, it's almost like Lightroom's edit tools, but I want to use Lightroom to edit everything. So this is basically what I'm going to do. I'm just going to use Affinity Photo 2 to do the tone mapping. And so you see on the top right there, there's a check mark and an X. We're going to tap on the check mark, which commits the tone map. And then I want to save this. So to save it, on the top left to the right of the app icon, you can see there's a little hamburger icon. I'm going to tap over there, and then I'm going to tap on export. Now, I want to export this out again as a 16-bit TIFF. I want to retain that format. So under preset, I'm going to tap over here and tap the next option, which is TIFF RGB 16-bit. But I don't want any compression, so I'm going to select none. And then for the file name here, I'll just title this urbex-hdr, and then I'll tap on OK. Now we have that familiar files dialog box here. So it's asking you, where do you want to save this? So I'm going to save it in the same HDR folder and tap save. Then I'm going to tap on that very top left icon, the little grid icon, to exit out of that document. Now, what we need to do is get that image into Lightroom. So let's swipe up over here and go back into Lightroom. And I'm just going to stick to this folder that we're already in. So now we need to import it. To import it, we're going to tap on the Add Photo button, which you can see it's on the bottom right in that little blue pill. It's the little photo icon with a plus icon next to it. I'm going to tap on it, and then I'm going to go to Files. And now I'm going to browse to that same folder. So it was under Affinity Photo and then HDR. And you can see there is the photo there, urbex-hdr. I'm going to tap on Open. and you can see that the photo was added. And now if I tap on the cloud icon, you can see that the photo is being synced to the cloud, so it's going to be available on all of my devices. Speaking of files, the one thing that you have to remember is you want to go back to your Files app and delete those, the original files that you exported, because those are big. They take up a lot of space. You don't need them anymore. You just needed them to do the actual tone mapping. So you'll swipe up over here. You can go to the Files app here. Let's go to HDR. And because everything has already been synced, I don't need any of these files anymore. I can tap on select on the top here, swipe down, tap delete, and just free up the space on my iPad. So that's one of those things that you want to remember. You want to make sure you do. All right, so that's how you can use Affinity Photo 2 as part of your Lightroom workflow to tone map an HDR photo. Now what I want to do is show you how to do basically the same thing, except instead of combining five photos together, we're going to take nine photos and stitch them to make one really wide photo as a panorama. So let's check that out. So similar as the tone mapped image, I went into this first photo and I made my edits, and then I copied the edits and I pasted them to the rest of the images. And you can see if I swipe over, this is basically a pano that I took from my parents' balcony using my iPhone 15 Pro Max. So it's actually pretty cool and I want to stitch it together. So just like before, the first thing we need to do is export these to the Files app. So tap and hold, and then tap the rest of the images that you want to export, and then tap on share. Now we'll go to export as, same settings as before. So all you need to do is tap on the check mark. Lightroom will start rendering those TIFF files and saving them out. Now let's go ahead and tap on save to files. And this time what I'll do is I'll go to on my iPad, Affinity Photo, then tap on Pano, tap on save. Now that those are saved, let's swipe up and go back to Affinity Photo. Just like before, we're going to tap on the new document here, and let's tap on new panorama. And just like before, what we need to do is load our photos. So let's tap on the cloud. We'll go to on my iPad, Affinity Photo, Pano, then we're going to select all of these. Then tap open. You can see we have all of our images added here. And so all you need to do is tap on stitch. And you can see there is kind of a low-res preview of what the stitch looks like. So when you're done, you'll tap on OK. And here we have our beautiful pano. So you can see, though, that we have some excess information where the stitching required to cut into the composition. So what I'll do is I'm going to pinch in and then tap on the crop icon on the left over here. And I'm just going to crop in just so that we don't have any of the transparent information. Basically, you want to maximize your overall canvas. So here, this looks good. So I'll tap on the hand icon over here and tap on the check button on the top right. Now all we need to do is export it. So tap on the hamburger icon, tap on export. And again, I'm going to use a 16-bit TIFF. So I'll tap on this option here and I'm going to turn compression off. It's going to result in a pretty big file. You can see it's 534 megabytes, but it's a really big file. So with that, let's tap on OK. We'll tap on my iPad, Affinity Photo, Pano, and I'm going to call this photo-pano. I know it's not very original, but when you're done, tap on save. And you can back out of this document. Now let's swipe up because we need to import it into Lightroom. So tap on Lightroom here. And just like before, we'll tap on the add button on the bottom right. From files, go to Affinity Photo, Pano, and then find your photo-pano, tap open. And there is our pano right over here. Because we made our edits first, everything is already consistent. It looks fantastic, but here's the cool thing. Look how much resolution we have. Look how much I'm able to pinch to zoom in and see all of that great detail. And that's without any additional sharpening added. I can go to edit over here, go to detail, you know, add some sharpening. I can also zoom in if I want and really see the sharpening being added. So that's looking good right around there. Let's pinch out and then remove sharpening from areas that we don't need it. Usually the sky and any flat areas. And there we go. If we go to the info view, you can see all of the information here. It still retains the metadata, which is great. And if my calculations are correct, we are working now with a 93 megapixel image, which is pretty awesome that we were able to do all of this on the iPad. And so that's how you can use your entire Lightroom library and still get Pano and HDR functionality using Affinity Photo 2. It's a pretty straightforward workflow. You just export your photos, import them into Affinity Photo 2, do what you need to do, and get them back into Lightroom. Just don't forget to go into the Files app and delete those original photos. You don't need those taking up space. Now, if you want to learn absolutely everything there is to know about using Lightroom's cloud-based ecosystem, whether it's on your desktop or your mobile devices, please check out my course called Lightroom Everywhere. Links are right down below. One of those amazing features that was recently added to Lightroom is local browse. I've got this video walking you through that right over here. If this video is helpful for you, a thumbs up is always appreciated. And be sure to hit that subscribe button, click on the bell icon to get notified of all future videos. Thanks a lot, everyone.